Hi, I'm Patrick. This is the Ask Patrick series. Today's question is, how do I justify the gap year? Okay, the question is by Amarjyoti Basu. Okay, how do I justify the gap year? Now, during this COVID time, it is comparatively easy to justify, saying that, okay, there was COVID, there was no job available, etc., etc., and you can justify. But let's try to create some ground rules. It's always good not to have a gap of more than 1 year. Okay, more than 1 year seem to be negative, right? So ensure that your gap is limited to max 1 year and not more than that. If you have a gap, some good ways to justify, because you will have to justify. I mean, it's all a panelist will always prefer a person who's working and cracking the exam than a person who's sitting at home and cracking the exam. So it is preferable if you can have an internship in you, which maybe online, maybe offline internships, where you work, show that you're working for some period of time, but ensure that these internships don't interfere with your preparation. Okay, because if you start taking internships and it takes a lot of your time and it affects your preparation as well, then it's negative. So ensure that these internships don't affect your preparation. So in that case, you can take up internships, ideally something which is relevant to what you want to do, and that should help you to justify your gap year. That's one way you can do. Second way you can do is maybe go in some online courses. Okay, ideally ones which are relevant that you want to do. I mean, get into the online courses. So you want to do marketing, get into social media marketing, digital marketing, do courses on that, get involved in that. So, but understand that when you do this, you should be prepared when you're answering the question in the interview. That's very important. I mean, just getting into is not, you have to also be prepared in terms of questioning for that. So assume that you don't done a course, so you'll be fairly comfortable with it. And because it's the area you want to get into, you will research on it. So that will help. Even better than that could be something relevant to the area you want to do. For example, if you want to get into finance, maybe invest in stock market, understand how the stock market works and mutual funds, etc. And maybe you can tell them that during this period, I was investing in the stock market. Second, maybe you can do, maybe if you look in marketing, digital marketing, social media marketing, start marketing. Create your own profiles. Try to increase the base in terms of number of users. You can tell them that I was marketing myself, understanding social media during this period of time. Better than that, maybe if you can do for someone else, can you invest for someone else? Can you maybe do social media marketing for someone else? Even that will do. So get into involved in all this, something that will help you for your interview. Last, what you can do is create a good hobby which you can talk in the interview. Having a good hobby where you have good knowledge base will also help in the interview phase. Okay, so where you build up your, so suppose you like to play guitar, try to play better guitar. I mean, learn more. I mean, go about it. That could help. So these things could help. I mean, internships, maybe some courses, maybe some practical exposure, maybe some hobby. Some of these things will definitely help you to build up as far as bridging the gap is concerned. But as I said earlier, avoid having a gap of more than 1 year. If you have a work ex, great. Continue doing your work as long as it doesn't affect your preparation. But ensure as far as possible, avoid having a gap of more than 1 year. Hope that helps. Thank you.